Let's get started. Option 1. Doing a full screen capture. To do a full screen capture, simply press the following key combination. Shift Command 3. You will hear familiar camera shutter sound, indicating that the capture was successful, followed by a screenshot in PNG or PNG format copied to the desktop. You can now do a quick look of the screenshot or open it in preview so that you can save the file in different formats, such as JPEG, TIFF or PDF. Incidentally, all screenshots copied to the desktop is named as follows: screenshot, followed by the date and time the screenshot was created and the PNG file format extension. You can now drag and drop the screenshot in your documents, as in our case, notes. Alternatively, if you wanted to capture the screenshot to the clipboard instead, simply press Ctrl Shift Command 3. Once again, you will hear the camera shutter sound, indicating the screenshot was captured to the clipboard. To paste the clipboard screenshot in your documents, or in our case notes, simply click Edit and click Paste, or you could use the keyboard shortcut Command V. Option 2. This is probably my favorite screen capture option. To capture windows, icons, dialog box, menu bar away from the background, simply press the following key combination. Shift Command 4. Now tap the space bar once. You will notice a light blue dimmed area with a tiny camera in its center. Now move the mouse and click on the item of the screen you wish to capture without the background. By the way, holding down the control key before clicking the item to be captured saves the screenshot to the clipboard instead. You can now drag and drop the screenshot in your documents or in notes as we did before. To capture the screenshot to the clipboard instead, simply press the following key combination, Ctrl Shift Command 4, and tap the space bar once. Option 3. Screen capture section or region of the screen. To activate section screen capture, simply press the following key combination, Shift Command 4. You will notice that this is the same key combination used in Option 2, but instead of the spacebar tab, click and hold down the mouse button. Now drag diagonally to create a rectangle. At this point, we could release the mouse button and capture the selected region. Instead, we'll keep holding down the mouse button in order to show you how to manipulate the rectangle in different ways. For example, say you wanted to move the rectangle anywhere on the screen, simply press and hold down the space bar. Release only the space bar when done. Now, while still holding down the mouse button, let's say we wanted to constrain the movement of the rectangle and resize it in the vertical direction only. Simply press and hold down the Shift key and instantly move the mouse up or down. You will notice that you are unable to move the mouse left or right or in the horizontal direction. Release only the Shift key when done. Similarly, to constrain the movement to only the horizontal direction, simply press and hold down the Shift key again, while instantly moving the mouse to the right or left direction, horizontally. Now, let's say we wanted to resize the rectangle from the center outwards or inwards. Simply press and hold down the Option key, or in some keyboards, the Alt key, and move the mouse inwards or outwards. Release the Option key when done. As mentioned before, releasing the mouse button at any time will take a screenshot of the selected region. However, if you wanted to save the screenshot to the clipboard after activating desktop screen capture key combination Shift Command 4, simply press and hold down the control key and release the mouse button. Now, if you wanted to cancel the screen capture procedure after activation for the desktop or clipboard, press the following, the escape key or the key combination Command period key. Now for a quick demo of Option 3. The object here is to capture a profile picture measuring exactly 358 by 358 pixels. Cue the demo. Thanks for watching, and thumbs up if you liked this video. And please don't forget to subscribe to be notified of the next episode from my OS X Adventures series. Thanks and peace.